Hello, everybody. We are here to start my first ever Madden franchise series with Madden 16 and the Chicago Bears. And there it is. A good offense, but the defense is shaky. Now I'm going to be creating a coach, and I debated between owner and coach, but I like the idea of being a coach better. I don't feel like doing all the financial baloney and all that stuff, so, you know, I'm just going to stick with being a coach. I think that's just fine. I'm going to be a strategist here. Now, this video is going to contain all four preseason games. It's going to be quick highlights. I'm not going to really do the normal thing that I do, like with my NCAA series, where, you know, I really go into deep detail of the highlights and covering most of the drives. Here, we're just going to hit on a lot of key plays, scoring plays, epic plays, you know, things that stand out, players that stand out. You're going to see that. Now, we're still going to cover each game with highlights, but it's going to be jumping around a lot. So we might, you know, skip 9 minutes of a quarter between highlights. You know, it's going to happen like that. So it's just going to be kind of an overview of the preseason game. It's still going to be a lot of highlights, but really, it's not the usual for me. Now, I'm sticking with the offensive playbook for now that Chicago has. And I didn't do it here, but I'm going with a 4-3 defense in real life. John Fox and the Bears doing like a 3-4 kind of thing. And I don't really like the 3-4 in this game. I was messing around with it in play now, and I didn't like it. And I'm going to just stick with kind of the standard 4-3 for now, anyway. We'll see if maybe play around with some stuff later, but at least this first season, I'm going to go with the Chicago offensive playbook. I'm going to go with 4-3 defense. Now, I'm playing on all Madden 15 minutes. The accelerated clock will go down to 15 seconds. And player progression frequency is actually going to be every 4 weeks. I didn't change that until a little bit after this was done, but I was going through all the main settings here. I turned off pre-existing injuries, because I've heard there's been issues with pre-existing injuries and the IR, so I just turned it off, figured we'll start everybody on a clean slate. Relocation settings. I don't really know how the computer does relocation itself, but I said everyone can relocate if they want to, I guess, so, you know, we'll see how that goes. It'd be interesting to see if it happened at some point, but, you know, one way or the other, I don't really care, necessarily. I do, but I don't, so there's that. Some of these assists, I've been messing around with. I mean, the big thing here is I'm playing a no-switch defense, which means that I decide on who I'm going to control on defense before the snap, and then once the ball snapped, I can't switch off that player. It's player lock without player lock, basically. I'm not hitting the player lock button, but I'm just not allowing myself to switch. I'm going to let the players, at least on defense, play to their ratings. I mean, pretty much does that on offense anyway, since, you know, everybody else is doing something else when you have the ball. So, if that made any sense to anybody listening, but I turned off all the, you know, assists for the computer. I want to be a full control as far as team management and team building. And we're going to get right into our first game of the preseason at Soldier Field in Chicago. Beautiful, beautiful evening, playing host to the Miami Dolphins, and a chance to see our players in action. Now, first quarter, the starters will be in on both sides. After that, the backups come in for the rest of the game from the second quarter on, so a glimpse of the starters in each of these games will be in the first quarter. Eddie Royal set to take this kick. Here we go. We're underway in Chicago. He gets across the 20, doesn't get much further. And that's how it starts on that kick return. Chicago would face a penalty. And second and 19 after that. Another flag comes down here as Cutler is sacked inside the 5-yard line. And oh boy, it just got worse for the Chicago Bears. What's the flag, though? Is it going to be holding against the defense? In fact, it is. So they are saved from that sack. A fortunate penalty their little play action for Jay Cutler, the starting quarterback, going to launch this for Alshon Jeffery. What a catch. The big-time receiver, he's the number one. And one of the things I've been kind of considering is when to get rid of Jay Cutler, because I'm honestly not much of a fan. It's not that he's all that bad, but he's not necessarily great. I want a quarterback who can really get the job done. I don't think Cutler's got much left in him. And he's got such a big contract, though. It's such a pain in the butt to try and shop him around because he's not that highly rated, but he has this contract that's just like, why? So yeah, we'll get into that later, but 3-0 right now, Bears lead after getting a field goal on that opening drive. Look at this sack! Look at that play by John Bostic. He came flying through the middle there. The middle linebacker does a great job there, and he could be really special this season for the Chicago Bears. Look at that. Boom. Of course, in real life, he doesn't. I believe he got traded to the Patriots, if that's right, but we're playing with the rosters as they were in the preseason, so just for anybody to clear up any confusion there, Ryan Tannehill finds his man, touchdown. They take the lead on that one. It'll be 7-0 here late in the first quarter, and we'll jump into the second quarter. Backups are in now, looking at Jimmy Colosin at quarterback for Chicago, rolling out, and he's going to find Mark Mariani here. He gets drilled, but it's worth it. That was a nice little play to the receiver. Chicago would stall, though, in Miami. Threatening. First and goal. Going to hand it off to Jay. I don't know. I haven't heard this guy's name enough to know how it's pronounced. I feel like I should know this, but I don't watch, like, Miami enough, so. Touchdown on the ground. The next play. They do a good job there. Matt Moore in at quarterback for the Dolphins. So they take a 14-3 lead here at Soldier Field. Jimmy Clausen going to drop back after being under center there. Find Zach Miller, the tight end here. He tries to pull off a juke move, but that was a nice little play there. He had his man beat. 3rd and 18 now, around midfield. The Bears got to get something here. Clausen looking, and that's a poor pass looking for Marcus Wilson, but that was way off target. Picked off. Crosses midfield. And the Dolphins have a chance to extend their lead here in this preseason opener. Inside of 2 minutes, Matt Moore going to empty the backfield. What are they going to do here? Bring a blitz. Doesn't pay off. Another touchdown for the second time today. That connection right there. And coach is not happy about that one. So, 1st and 10, Clausen going to drop back to pass again here, looking to throw, and he tries to find Marcus Wilson again, and it's intercepted again. Trying to fit that in a very tight window, not good. So the Dolphins 3rd and 1 have a chance to really try and push this lead. Look at this pass, a beautiful pitch and catch. Defense was pressing, they were bringing a blitz, and it did not pay off. So 28-3, things just got out of hand with those interceptions. Clausen trying to redeem himself a little bit, and this was a nice pass and catch. Look at that, Mark Mariani again. Couple of nice receptions for him so far. Trying to make a name for himself and make a statement, because there's some solid receivers on this Chicago Bears team here. Looking, there is Zach Miller. Very formidable tight end. Of course, he has Martellus Bennett in front of him, but nonetheless, Miller is a good tight end in his own right. Jimmy Clausen looking, finds Marcus Wilson over the middle. This time, nobody intercepts it, and it's a touchdown. First one of the series goes to Marcus Wilson. I think he could be a special receiver. Develop him a little bit, and he could be something else. We go to the second half now. 28-10, Miami leading. Late in the third quarter here, and the handoff stuffed. The defense was all over that one. 3 players arrived quickly to stop that one. 3rd and goal. What will the defense do here? Will they bring pressure like they've done before, or will they sit back in coverage? Looks like they are going to drop back a little bit instead. Still doesn't pay off. They run a very similar play, same route in the same area of the field as they did last time. 35-10, not looking pretty. Here in the fourth quarter, just going to take a shot. This is David Fales in at quarterback. He finds John Childs. That was Marcus Wilson. I thought that, for some reason, I thought that was Childs. It was not. It was Wilson. David Fales and that quarterback out of San Jose State. Fumble. Marcus Wilson again, and he couldn't hold on to it. It was a nice pass in tight coverage. Ball comes out. Miami would get another touchdown, 42-10, and that was a bad second quarter. Otherwise, I mean, it wasn't a terrible game, but the second quarter really hurt the Bears, and as you can see, nice attack from Miami. 268 passing, 148 rushing, good balance. And after week one, Pat Devlin and D.D. Lattimore, quarterback and linebacker respectively, have been cut from the team. More cuts need to be made, but that's what these games are for. Somebody make a statement and say, I should be on this team. At Indianapolis, the Bears hoping to get a win here. Of course, results in preseason don't really matter all that much, but man, you like to have some momentum. Look at Eddie Royal. Doesn't quite have the second gear to take it all the way, but that was a nice return. A good start for the Chicago Bears here. What can they do on the road in Indianapolis? Finds Alshon Jeffrey over the middle. Could have been picked off, but a nice catch by number 17 and a good start to the game. Several plays later, out of the shotgun, Jay Cutler looking to pass all day to throw Matt Forte, the running back. Struggled to get going. And really, all the run game in that Miami game was very difficult to establish. Up front, they were very good. And here, Kadeem Carey gets into the end zone. Solid play by the second-year man out of Arizona. 7-0, Chicago. Gets off to a nice start. Andrew Luck going to run a little play action here. Going to roll out to his left. Throws to his right. Finds Fleener. What a weird play this was. He breaks off the tackle. Still won't be brought down. And he's pushed out of bounds. A big gain there. And the Colts have a chance to score. Third and goal at the 9. Luck under center. What's going to happen here? Looking to pass. And he just looks for Frank Gore. That was going nowhere. It looked like his deep routes in the end zone were covered. 7-3 now. Cutler gonna throw again here. He has Jaquizz Rodgers. Look at the spin move. Rodgers trying to pull off another spin move, but a great play. And the running backs that the Bears have, they have some talented running backs. They have Forte, Kadeem Carey, Jaquizz Rodgers, Jeremy Langford. Solid core of run backs. Cutler on a little play action, looking deep for the end zone. Alshon Jeffrey, what a catch in the end zone. And he made that look easy. Coverage was pretty solid by Indianapolis, but Jeffrey comes up with the big catch. That's why he's the number one man here in Chicago. 14-3. We're nearing the end of the first quarter. The starters nearing the end of their time here. And Pernell McPhee gets the initial hit. The fumble comes out. Jarvis Jenkins. Are we going to have a fat man touchdown if Andrew Luck doesn't catch him? Fat man touchdown. But wait, there's a flag on the play that might just ruin the whole thing. Indeed, the holding came after the fumble, so the Bears retain possession. But Fat Man touchdown is erased, and as such, the Bears take over just around midfield here. Look at this play to Kevin White. Breaks off a tackle, breaks off two more tackles. Kevin White's gone. Nobody touches him. And one play after the touchdown by Jarvis Jenkins was taken back by the penalty. Kevin White brings down the house. 21-3 as we enter the second quarter. Hand off to Jaquizz Rodgers. And another deadly spin move. Rodgers, can he beat him? He's gone! Jaquizz Rodgers has torched the Colts defense. What a run. 44-yard carry for the man out of Oregon State. 28-3. It has just opened up for the Bears here in Indianapolis. And Antrell Roll gets an interception. Poor Matt Hasselbeck. Just not a very good throw. Bears would not capitalize, but they would pin the Colts deep in their own territory. Hasselbeck under center. Going to hand it off here to Heron. And he's met immediately by a host of Bears defenders. Look at how many guys were in the backfield. Where's the blocking, guys? 28-3, halftime score. The Bears looking very good on both sides of the ball. Now we enter the second half. Jaquizz Rodgers again. Look at the game. Rodgers is having a breakout performance, proving he deserves to be on this team. What an effort. Here, Jimmy Clausen going to look, and it's Marcus Wilson. That's a catch to remember. Another player looking to make a statement for why he should still remain on this team. Spots are up for grabs, specialized backups. This is what they're playing for. Kadeem Carey gets out wide, diving for the end zone. He gets in for the second time today. Good job. The running backs are having a great day for the Bears. 35-6. Colts would tack on a field goal. Hasselbeck looking to throw, almost picked off again. Great coverage by the defensive backs there. And that would set up a 1st and 5 after a little penalty, offside penalty, in fact, by the Bears here. Hasselbeck has all day to throw, going to roll out before he's hit. What a destructive hit by Ego Ferguson. Hasselbeck knocked out. That would be the end of his day, and 38-9 would be the final score. A couple more field goals put down by both teams. Jaquizz Rodgers, the star of the game. Look at the yardage, 463. As you can see, I'm not really running over the individual stats. I'm not really looking to cover that. I'm kind of just want to cover the performances that are important. And here's week two cuts. Bryce Callahan, Thomas Gafford, Cinnarus Perry. Among the names, a couple tight ends cut, a couple cornerbacks cut. Didn't think they were all that great, didn't put in that great of performances. And we have a trade for defensive tackle Michael Brockers of the Ravens. Now, I don't have a problem trading draft picks away because we can get them back. We can trade them back. Here's Michael Brockers. Really needed another defensive tackle, especially running a 4-3. The defensive tackle was a very weak spot for the Bears coming in, so Brockers, not the greatest defensive lineman, but he's going to add something at least valuable at the defensive tackle spot here. Now we go on the road to Cincinnati. Andy Dalton goes down, and the 1-1 Bears looking to get their second preseason win here. It's a tough Cincinnati Bengals team here. Dalton looking to throw. Has all day. Look at this play. Beautifully done. And Kyle Fuller just got flat out beat. Man to man on that play. That's not very good. You don't want that to happen if you're trying to prove yourself. You're 7-0 early. And they get the ball right back. I mean, Dalton, good grief, gets hit by Lamar Houston. There's Jared Allen. Probably the last year on the team for him. I don't plan on keeping him around. If he doesn't retire before then, that is. Dalton again, just so much time to throw. AJ Green, what a catch! Diving just short of the goal line. He was marked down short, so it'd be another touchdown. They would punch it in. 14-0 early here. Cutler gonna just dump it off here to Alshon Jeffrey, who breaks off a tackle. Look at this effort by Jeffrey. Fighting for those yards. That's what we want to see, but that drive would abruptly end here. Look at Jeremy Hill spinning out of a tackle. Look at another spin move, breaks tackle, and this has to be the greatest run I have ever seen a computer do against me. I've played football video games for years, and I have never seen the computer bust off a run like that. That was unreal by Jeremy Hill. Look at this. Spins out of that one, spins there, breaks a tackle. That's poor defending, but that's just a great effort as well by the running back. Unbelievable. 21-0 here. Backups are in the game. Second quarter action. AJ McCarron at quarterback for the Bengals. He's going to find Hamilton, and it's a blowout early. Things are not looking good for the Bears in this game. I mean, the Bengals are a solid team, but put up a fight here, Bears. Come on, somebody do something. Look at that play. The defender misses it by inches, and it costs the defense a touchdown. He was inches away from making the play and knocking the ball down. Instead, it's a touchdown. Cincinnati extends their lead to 35. And a nice pass by AJ McCarron. Just look how close that was right there. Nearly swatted or even picked off. Can Jimmy Clausen lead this offense and at least get a score before halftime? Rodgers, a nice amount of room to run. He's had a very solid preseason. Later in the drive, 3rd and 10. Clausen rolling out to his right, has all kinds of room to run, and this isn't exactly the best thing that he does, but he steps out of bounds and gets 15. Solid run. It would be 4th down. And instead of taking the field goal, the Bears want a touchdown. They just want to get some more points on the board. Wilson had it, but he had to come back, dropped it. Didn't matter. That would end the drive and the half at 38-0. Second half of action, play action for McCarron. Gonna look, finds Kyle Fuller, the defensive back who got burned earlier. Makes a statement here, intercepts the ball. It was a off-target pass. He comes up with it. Can they find an answer? Can Jimmy Clausen get something going? Finds Zach Miller in a crowd of defenders. Miller has all kinds of room to run. Can he beat one final defender? Pushed out inside the 10, a 75-yard gain by Zach Miller. Oh, that was a beautiful play. And I'm going to give the little toss play to Jaquizz Rodgers. Touchdown, finally on the board. And this game, reminiscent of the Miami game, just got out of hand. Another field goal for Cincinnati, so it's 41-10. Late in the third. Here we see David Fales rolling off to his left, finds Marcus Wilson after he drew a defender to him. That was a nice play by the quarterback to buy some more time and space. Now Rodgers going to get the handoff. No play action. It's going to be just a poor throw. Too much air looking for Zach Miller. And that cost him a touchdown here. McCarron's going to get sandwiched. Look at that play. He was brought down way back there. Great sack by two defensive linemen. Game ends 41-10. Bears get blown out. It wasn't pretty, but not going to get too worried just yet. Here's the week 3 cut. 6 players had to be chopped off the roster, including quarterback Shane Carden, rookie, Anthony Jefferson, strong safety rookie, and we go into the final preseason game, 1-2. Against the Cleveland Browns. Chance to build some confidence here going into the season opener. Alshon Jeffrey has been a beast, and he will be a beast so long as he remains healthy. Jay Cutler looking for another pass here. It's Eddie Royal. Look at Royal fighting for the tough yards. Gotta love that in a player. 1st and 17 following a penalty. Many penalties actually happened on this drive. It was very weird. But typical of preseason, look at this. Cutler on the run. Alshon Jeffrey with an unbelievable catch. It was a spot-on throw by Jay Cutler, who was rolling to his right. And as he was, he put the ball in the perfect place for the great receiver to make a catch. Look at that. Reaching back with the one hand, an Odell-esque catch. Alshon Jeffrey, one of the receivers who can certainly make those kinds of catches. 7-0. And a quick 3-and-out for the Cleveland Browns gives this opportunity for Matt Forte to run through defenders. Forte had one man to beat. He didn't have the breakaway speed, but oh boy, that was a great run through defenders. Later in the drive, it's 2nd and 3. Cutler under center. Going to run a little play action pass here, rolling out to the right again and finds Martellus Bennett. The second time that Cutler was rolling out to his right, he finds a man for the touchdown. This time it's the big-time tight end Martellus Bennett. Johnny Manziel, what can he do to try and spark this Cleveland Browns offense? Well, that's not what you want when you're trying to spark the offense. Lamar Houston gets the sack there. 2nd quarter of play, backups are in as usual. West gets the handoff. Look at this. Nice little run, got some solid blocking that at least allowed him some space. 23 yards on his first carry of the game. 1st and goal. What are they going to do here? Lewis going to find his man wide open. Touchdown. Browns are on the board and it's suddenly a game, everybody. 14-7. As we enter the second half, it was a pretty uneventful end of the first half, and here we see a fumble by Clausen picked up by Kadeem Carey, and he was stuffed there. He had no chance of really making anything of that. And now Connor Shaw comes in the game. He gets destroyed by Will Sutton. A nice sack by the defensive tackle. Second sack of the game for this defense here. He just came flying through. Didn't give Shaw a chance. And punting situation for the Bears here. O'Donnell's going to send this one away. Looking, it's going off to the left here, and it goes out at the 2-yard line. What a punt! Best punt of the preseason so far. Pinned back now, Shaw going to hand off to West, who's met the defenders, stuff him in the end zone. It's a safety! Excellent job. You see all the defenders who came up to make this play. West wasn't going to fight out of this tackle here. Excellent job. 16-7. Bears would not be able to make anything of the ensuing possession, so chance for Connor Shaw and the Browns to try and get back within one score here. Shaw throwing under pressure, way too much air under this one, and Kyle Fuller gets his second interception of the preseason. And aside from a couple plays, Fuller has had a very solid preseason. And he could be working his way up the depth chart, as there are some older defensive backs on this team. And he's one of the younger guys. So 19-7 is the lead for Chicago in the fourth quarter. Shaw, the third string quarterback, and throws off target. He's had a rough day. Defense has been in his face, causing problems. Look at this coverage by Porter. Unbelievably well done. Knocking the ball out. We'll get another look at this one because this was great coverage. Tight all the way. Kept his eyes on the receiver, played the ball beautifully, and it looks like he may have got there just a little bit early, but no call for pass interference, so it's 19-10 now. They got a field goal there. Look at this play. Shaw gonna get sacked. Cornelius Washington. And that's the fourth time that he was sacked, or that the defense picked up a sack, so... 3rd and 16 for the Bears. Finds Jaquizz Rodgers. Rodgers has space. Can he beat the man? He has so much speed. Nobody's going to catch him. Jaquizz Rodgers gets a receiving touchdown and caps off a fantastic preseason for the running back out of Oregon State. 26-10. That's going to put this one away unless the Browns can score quickly here. Shaw going to look to throw. Not surprising. He's feeling some pressure. They've been in his face just about every play. That's a very ill-advised throw. Picked off by Amos. Excellent job. David Fales, credit for that touchdown pass to Rodgers' last drive. And here, I don't think we got any Jeremy Langford highlights, but he was very disappointing in this preseason. Powerful runner that he is, didn't do a whole lot. Kadeem Carey, Jaquizz Rodgers did much better at the running back position there. As you can see, the 425 yards of total offense to 296. The Browns really struggled. They would get a late touchdown. 26-18 is the final. 100% red zone for both teams, which is pretty solid. But look at the 12 penalties for 100 yards. The Bears got to work on that. We're going to look at the final cuts. Joshua Bellamy at wide receiver. Didn't see much out of him. Really looked at some performances in this preseason. I actually didn't end up showing the stats for this. I totally forgot to look at their total stats for the preseason, but it's not that big of a deal. It's preseason, so. Christian Jones, I really wanted to find a reason to keep him, but I just didn't see it. The other middle linebackers were a lot better, in my opinion. Brandon Dunn, you're done. Get out of here. Take a look at a couple other positions. I really struggled with this one, but Jeremy Langford, you know, he's a rookie. Could have given him maybe a bigger chance. I liked what he did at Michigan State. Solid player, but I liked what Kadeem Carey and Rodgers were doing. Obviously, Forte, I'm not going to cut him. So Langford ends up getting cut from the team. You know, we received a couple small penalties to the cap, but it's not like anything huge. Terrence Mitchell, cornerback, gets cut. You know, these were pretty minor penalties. And I was willing to take the penalties to cut these players off the team because they weren't really contributing much. So, that's it, guys. We'll just get a very brief look at kind of how the depth chart's looking at the moment. before we head in to week one, and that'll be in the next video here. No surprises, Cutler at quarterback, Forte number one running back, Jeffrey, White, and Royal in the top three receivers. Michael Brockers in a defensive tackle with Jared Allen, Goldman, and Houston around him. No real surprises here, but you never know what's going to happen. Anything can. It's going to be week one against the Green Bay Packers, an NFC North game to kick off the season. I'll see you all next time.